In this packet tracer activity, file and data integrity checks, you will verify the integrity of multiple files using hashes to ensure files have not been tampered with. If any files are suspected of being tampered with, they are to be sent to Sally's PC so that she can further analyze the contents. The IP addressing, network configuration, and service configurations are already complete. You will use the client devices to verify and transfer any suspected files. In this activity, you will also use the CSE Lab VM. This activity makes use of the branch office, headquarters, and ISP locations. Inside the branch office, we will use laptop BR1 to access the BR server. In the ISP telco, there is a DNS server. And in headquarters, we will use Sally's laptop, HQ Laptop 1, and Bob's laptop, HQ Laptop 2. Inside the wiring closet, there is an FTP server that we will be accessing from the command line. Part 1. Recover files after a cyber attack. Client data must be secured and remain unchanged by unauthorized personnel. By hashing data before and after it is archived, you can tell if it has been changed even by one character or even one bit because the hashes will not match. In this part, you will attempt to recover files from a backup after a cyber attack. Step 1. Access the BR server from Mike's PC. Click Branch Office, then click Laptop BR1. Click the Desktop tab, and then click Web Browser. Enter the URL branch.corp and click Go. Packet Tracer may take up to a minute to converge. You can click Fast Forward Time to speed up the process. Click the link to download the most current files. And we can see that the website has been hacked. If you click the fast forward button, you will see more graphics load. I clicked it 6 times. Step 2 is copy the hash values from the last time the files were archived. You need to restore the missing files from a backup server located in HQ. But first, you need the hashes for the stored files. These hashes will be used to ensure the integrity of the backup files. Enter the URL hq.corp. Click the link to view the most recent files and their hashes. Select and copy all the content. Open the CSE Lab VM and then click Menu, Text Editor, Pluma. Paste the contents of your clipboard into the blank document. You will use these hashes to validate whether or not a file is corrupted. Step 3 is download the backup files to Mike's PC. Close the web browser and then click Command Prompt. Connect to HQ FTP server by entering ftp.hq.corp. Enter the username of Mike and a password of Cisco 123. Enter the dir command to view the current files stored on the FTP server. Download the 6 client files to Mike's PC. End the FTP session and enter the dir command to verify the client files are now on laptop BR1. Part 2. Use hashing to verify file integrity. In this part, use the CSE Lab VM to hash the contents of the files you downloaded. You will then compare the new hash to the old hash to see if the data has changed. Any files that have changed since they were archived will be sent to Sally so that she can investigate the changes at a later time. Step 1 is check the hashes of the client files on Mike's PC. Close the command prompt and then click Text Editor. Click File Open and select the first document, northeastclients.txt, and then click OK. Copy the entire text document contents. Open the CSE Lab VM. Double-click the terminal icon. Use the echo-n command and paste in the file contents between single quotes, and then pipe the content to the md5 sum command. This will create a hash to validate the data in the northeastclients.txt file. Compare the hash value created here with the hash value you copied to the text document earlier. This hash starts with 4DFF. Northeast Clients is 4DFF. Notice that they are the same. Therefore, you know northeastclients.txt is not corrupted. Hash the contents of the remaining five files until one of the values does not match the computed hash. The sc-clients.txt hash does not match. Therefore, Mike sends Sally an email about the corrupted file. I have already written the email. The branch.corp website has been hacked. I've restored all the files except for sc-clients.txt. The hashes do not match. And then I pasted in the old hash and the new hash. Return to Packet Tracer and close the text editor. Click Email and then Compose. Write an email and send it to Sally at branch.corp to tell her that the file server has been hacked. Step 3 is download the suspected file to Sally's PC. Navigate to the HQ site and then click HQ Laptop 1. Click Desktop tab, Command Prompt, and then enter ftphq.corp to connect to the HQ FTP server. Enter the username Sally and the password Cisco321. Enter the dir command to view the current file stored on the HQ FTP server. Download the sc-clients.txt file. End the FTP session and then enter the dir command to verify the tampered client file is now on HQ Laptop 1. Sally will analyze this file later. Part 3. Use HMAC to verify file integrity. Bob is the CFO and is currently located at HQ. In this part, you will compute and verify a hash-based message authentication code, or HMAC, of a critical file to ensure that it is the same data since the last time the file was used. HMAC requires a secret key before the file integrity can be validated. Within HQ site, open HQ Laptop 2. Click Desktop and then Command Prompt, followed by the dir command. Verify the critical file named income.txt is on the laptop. Close the Command Prompt window. Click Text Editor and then File Open. Click the income.txt document and click OK. Select and copy all the content. In the CSE Lab VM, open a new Pluma document. Paste the contents from your clipboard into the new document. Save the document as income.txt. Close the document. Click the terminal window. At the command prompt, enter the following command. This will create an HMAC for the file income.txt. Note the secret key Cisco123. Verify that the computed hash matches the hash stored in the file earlier. And the hashes match. This concludes this packet tracer activity, file and data integrity checks.